we are just about ready. Stokes getting the start. And I have to turn my light on my phone here so I can read the starting lineups. Yeah, Kayshawn Stokes, junior guard out of Headland, Alabama. Number five, Daquan Morris, sophomore guard out of Pine Bluff. Number 11, Brandon Brown, junior guard out of Memphis, Tennessee, 6'5", 210-pounder. Number 15, A.J. Stridick, junior out of Bay City, Texas. And number 55, 6'1", guard out of Little Rock, Arkansas, senior Sean Williams, rounding out the starting five for the Golden Lions. But head coach Spencer Robertson was not happy about the long delay between the two teams having their lineups being unveiled. And so they're already in a little grumpy mood to start the game. Gold Lions in their home blacks. I mentioned it's a black out. It's usually road jerseys. But they look good. They got the black and gold trim on the front, the back of the jerseys. Gold Lions on the side of the shorts. But the primary look is black here in the blackout. Opening tip's going to go to Prairie View A&M. We are underway here on this Saturday evening on the UAPB Sports Network. First possession of the ball game. They'll work it around the perimeter here. 14 on the shot clock. Zone defense here for the Golden Lions. Nice dump off down low. Oh, a lot of contact. No call. UAPB with the steal. Backdoor drop. The dunk. Beautiful lob, Brandon Brown, and the elevator man, Daquan Morris, up, up, and away, soaring the baseline with the two-handed lob and jam. All starts with the beautiful feed, and then Morris smashes it home with two hands. Free throw. He was fouled as well. Makes the free throw. 3-0 UAPB. Couldn't ask for a better start. So get a defensive. Get a steal and then a lob and three-point play on the dunk. Strong drive. Douglas gets it taken away. Gets it back after he lost it. Kicks it out. Three-point shot. Gambrill. Book it. Jeremiah Gambrill, 6'3", sophomore guard out of Houston, Texas, ties the game 3-3. Morris, the drive, kick, Brown in the lane, behind the back pass, straight it goes up, shot partially blocked by Markidrick Bell. Bell, 6'7". Forward out of Starville, Mississippi. Long shot, no good. Wrestling away the rebound is Brown. He's like a freight train going downhill. Right at the basket, contact. Couldn't get the call, gets it taken away, and right back on the other end. Bell gets the basket. 5-3, two-point lead for Prairie View. 2 minutes into the ball game. Williams, a kick out. Morris spots up for three, got it. Daquan Morris. And Morris has six to lead all scorers early. 6-5, Golden Lions back up by one.
There goes, he goes. He got to play, man. He got to play. Lock up, lock up. He'll
look, he'll look up. Here on the right wing, Daniels. Now kicks it back out, working around the perimeter. Three-point shot for Douglas is good. Will Douglas. 8-6, 2-point lead for Prairie View. Brown needs some help. Morris comes out high near midcourt to get it. Off the bounce now. Brown, the kick out, back to Morris. Williams spots up for three. Yes, sir. Sean Williams hits the triple. Golden Lions back on top, 9-8. Pretty good flow to this one early on. And they want a trap right in front of the Golden Lion bench. And, oh, that should have been a backcourt. I don't think it was touched. That's just going to be backcourt. And it's going to be a turnover. 9-8. 1-point lead for the Golden Lions. 16:52 to play in a nice tempo to this game early on. Golden Lions will inbound it. Get it to Williams. Sean Williams, he can blow up and have a 30-point game on you. So watch him if he gets off to a hot start. Morris driving baseline, slams on the brakes. Stokes in the lane, strong drive, gets it blocked from behind, however, by Gambrill. Prairie View with the basketball, they trail by one. Almost a steal by Morris. Driving right side of the lane, shot up. We're gonna wave it off. Wave off the shot. Douglas was fouled on the drive. Daquan Morris, and it's his first and team foul number one. No inbound it here to Cox. Cox drives left side of the lane, stripped by Williams and stolen. They give it right back. And let's see, we're gonna have a foul. And it's gonna be on Milton, scrambling for that loose ball. Picks up the foul. So 16:06 to play. Early first half. Prairie View will inbound it, trailing UAPB by one. Prairie View set. Inbounded here. Gambrill. Right side to Daniels, picked up by Brown. Daniels still with the bounce. Step back, 17-footer, no good, draws the foul. Gonna say pushed off. Or did they call? Oh, they called the foul on Brown, so you got him on the arm on the shot. It's going to lead us to a media timeout. We'll step aside, take a one-minute break here. 15:55 remaining, first half. This is Golden Lion basketball on the UAPB Sports Network. Golden Lions up by one over Prairie View, back in 1 minute. Golden Lions up by one over Prairie View. And pretty good start. To this one so far, Golden Lions 3 of 5 from the field. Both teams shooting well, 70%, 75% for Prairie View. They're 3 of 4. Now they've hit a couple of threes, 2 for 3. The Golden Lions 2 for 2 on their three-point shots. First free throw, no good for Prairie View as Jawan Daniels, a 6'7 junior out of Harlem, New York, out of Odessa College. He'll make 1 of 2. Early on, leading scorer, 6 points, Sean Williams. Daquan Morris, I believe, should have 6. A little typo there. The Golden Lions unable to score on their end. Right back comes Prairie View. Williams, however, for Pine Bluff for the steal. Now to Morris, to Brown, and he'll lay it up and in with the left hand. Beautiful break. Timeout. Let's see. We've got a, gonna have a coach's warning. Gonna say out of the box. I got a little coach's area, restricted area. They not allowed to get out of the coach's box. So 11-9, UAPB by 2. 15 remaining here. Lost control for a moment. It's going to be a travel call, and Coach Spencer Robinson's quickly going to substitute, bring in Jeremiah Kendall. As Will Douglas will take a seat after that turnover. So the Golden Lions up by 2 with the basketball. Long three, top of the key. This time rims out for Williams. 5 minutes in, 2-point game. Golden Lions by a deuce. Gambrell on the bounce. Gives it up and gets it right back. Doolittle in the game for the Golden Lions. Driving baseline, nice block by Milton. Prairie View gets it back. Well, running hook shot, no good. Put back dunk, no good. But the third chance is the charm. It's going to be an and one opportunity here for Markeedrick Bell. Markeedrick Bell, former UAPB player. You can hear the student section a little bit giving him the business. Markeedrick Bell, 6'7". He's out of Starville, Mississippi, but he transferred from UAPB to Prairie View. But they actually, it was Jeremiah Kendall with the basket in the three-point play, I think. Or they had to take Bell out of the game. Not sure what happened there. Nevertheless, it's 12-11. 1-point lead for Prairie View after that 3-point play. Golden Lions trying to regain the lead here. Top of the key, Williams, 10 on the shot clock. Looking for a screen. Now, strong drive by Stokes, gets it blocked from behind, and a foul called on Jeremiah Kendall. Stops the clock at 14:03 to play here in the first half. And was on the drive, so it's going to be 2 shots. All right. Driving to the basket, attempting to shoot while he was fouled, rather. Kayshawn Stokes will shoot a pair. Junior guard. Only 6'2", but may have the best leaping ability on the team. As he can really elevate off the floor quickly. He's out of Headland, Alabama, but he really can get up. He and Morris both, that would be fun to watch those two. Maybe in a dunk contest. Also, 13-12 after Stokes knocks down both free throws, regaining the lead for the Golden Lions. Nearly 6 minutes into the first half here. Pressure, now they back off. Pick up at midcourt with Williams. Gambrill, look out from behind, nearly a steal, great effort. But they got numbers on the other end and booked the three from the left wing. Jeremiah Gambrill, his second triple of the first half. Lead back up by two. Williams, he'll pull the trigger, short on the three. Rebound Prairie View, they'll push it ahead. Here's Bell on the baseline. Turnaround jumper from 15 is good. Markedrick Bell puts the Panthers up by four. 17-13. Bell's got four in the game. Biggest lead for Prairie View so far. Morris needs some help. Gets it out to Brown. Brown top of the key. Back out to Morris. Morris, strong drive up and under. No good, but there to clean up the mess was Omar Parchman. 6-8 forward for Wynn, Arkansas. Long three, right wing, no good. Brown the rebound for Pine Bluff. Can Tyre take the lead here? 17-15 Prairie View. Here's Williams. Keeps his dribble alive. Now top of the key. Turnaround from 12. Will not go, offensive rebound. Brandon Brown's got it for Pine Bluff and he's fouled. 12:21 to play in the first half. It's the first foul on Gambrill and team foul number three on Prairie View. Gabriel Vargas and Milton both will check in. Morris and Williams take a seat. Vargas to inbound it. 20 on the shot clock. He gets it to Milton. Top of the key, 12 on the shot clock. Milton, strong drive, absorbs the contact. Shot up, no good. Gets his own rebound off the glass, no good. Stick back try for Streetick, he missed it. Some contact there on that putback, but it's going to be Panther basketball as the Golden Lions had three shots at it. Prairie View up by two with the basketball. 11:45 to play. First half, and could not get the roll that time. Douglas with the miss. Here's Brown in the lane, kicks it right corner for three. Yes, sir. Stokes hits the big three, and the Golden Lions back up by one. 18-17, 11:25 to play first half. Pull up 15-footer, right wing, no good for Douglas. And the Golden Lions clear the rebound. Here's Brown on the baseline, kick out Vargas. Quickly over to Stokes, this time from the left side. Yes, sir. Kayshawn Stokes hits a three from the right side, this time from the left side. And the Golden Lions up 21-17. And it's going to be a full timeout here. We will step aside with 11 minutes to play. First half, UAPB 21, Prairie View 17. This is the UAPB Sports Network back in 1 minute. We'll be right back. 11 minutes to play here in the first half. Game's going back and forth. The Golden Lions lead it 21-17. Back-to-back triples from Kayshawn Stokes. And Stokes off to a good start. He's got 8 points in the first 9 minutes of the game. It's going to be Prairie View basketball as we resume play here. A little bit of token pressure as Gambrell will bring it up for the Panthers. Daniels now top of the key to Cox. Here's Bell. He likes that area. He'll pass it up this time. 15-footer left side for Cox is no good, but going to say hit him on the elbow, and two free throws coming up for Dwayne Cox, 6'2 senior guard out of Ripley, Mississippi. Played at East Mississippi Community College.
And the line will be number 11, Dwayne Cox.
Cox to the line for two shots, 10:37 to go before halftime. Gets the friendly roll on the first. Doolittle checks in for Milton.
One shot remaining for Cox.
And one more coming up. Cox takes his time. And takes a sweet time. Makes both free throws, cuts it to a 2-point game, 21-19. And Vargas will bring it up for Pine Bluff. Left side to Doolittle. The drive, kick in the corner. Stokes, this time he'll drive and kick it back out. Here's Brown, top of the key. Three-pointer by Doolittle off the left wing, no good. Battling for the rebound is Brown, and he tried to, well, he tried to save it. Not able to do so, so the Golden Lions will get it back. Vargas will inbound it. They'll get 20 on the shot clock. Underneath, Doolittle misses a bunny underneath, a whistle and a tie-up. Alternating possession is going to remain Pine Bluff ball. Sean Williams back in. Trevante Doolittle, the senior, checks out. So 16 on the shot clock. We'll throw it out high here to Vargas. Quick pass. Williams thought about the three. Now they'll set it back up top of the key here. In the corner, Stokes, the baseline drive, kick out. Vargas did not get it off, it partially blocked, but that shot clock awareness. The shot clock violation and made one too many passes. .951 to play. Again, the student section giving head coach Byron Smith and company a heck tonight, as since they moved the benches across the court, it gives an advantage a little bit to the student section sitting right behind the sideline. I mentioned earlier, I said Spencer Robertson, head coach of Byron Smith. Been in the SWAC for a number of years now. Golden Lions up by two here, 21-19. Strong drive, up first layup is there for Daniels. ties it up at 21. Strong drive by Brandon Brown as he'll get right up in your chest and use that big frame of his and built like a football player, 6'5", 210 guard. But he's solid. Tied at 21 here, 9:18 to play before halftime. Here's Williams off the curl and whistle, and gonna have an illegal screen, I believe.
Offensive foul called on AJ Stradic for the
Stradic. Parchman will check in. That's already three on Stradic. Team foul number seven. Top of the key here, picked up. Now they want to trap off the hands. Oh, I believe that was a backcourt. Here is a steal by Williams. Williams, nice pass. Morris, a lot of contacts. He missed it. Trying to bend his body and kiss it off the glass. Knocked out of bounds. It'll stay Pine Bluff ball. .48 to play. 21 all. Williams will inbound it. 20 on the shot clock for Pine Bluff. We'll get it to Morris here. Morris, the drive. Turns, shot up. No good in the lane. Knocked out of bounds. This time it's going to be Prairie View ball. As Coach Bozeman was wanting a foul there. Thought he got hit on the arm as he shot it. Definitely been a lot of contact both ways. Really been letting them play. They'll set it up here right side to Douglas. Now hand it off to Gambrill. Picked up by Morris. Right side to Douglas. Wants to drive baseline. Shot clock at five. Daniels had to take the long two. No good. Tip, no good. The third chance here. Foul call is Jeremiah Kendall. It's going to go to the line for two shots.
Hey, take your respect to seat, brother. Take your respect to seat. Both side of you. Both side of you.
8 minutes, 10 seconds to play before halftime. And Jeremiah Kendall will shoot two here, trying to regain the lead. First shot is good. One more coming up for Kendall. And second shot is good. 4 in a row here for Prairie View. They retake the lead 23-21. A little over 8 to play before halftime. Here's Williams. He'll take the three, left wing, short, no good. Battle for the rebound. He'll get it back. Quickly, top of the key, Vargas. Brown spots up for three. Yes, sir. Brandon Brown with the big three on the right wing. The Golden Lions back up by one. 24-23, 7:37 to play. First half. Next dead ball will be a media break. Inside Kendall. Baseline drop off to Bell. Gets it knocked away, stolen by Stokes. Ahead to Williams. Top of the key, Williams wants to drive in the lane. And trying to drop it off at the last second. He's going to be fouled. There's the dead ball and the timeout coming. Media break. We'll step aside for 1 minute here. 7:16 to play before halftime. This is the UAPB Sport Network coverage of a 24-23 UAPB 1-point lead over Prairie View. Back in 1 minute.
Hey, take your hand back to your board. Hey, you got 20 seconds.
I see a little, it takes us a minute to catch up. .16 remaining here in the first half. UAPB leads at 24-23 over Prairie View A&M. It's been a good first half so far. Had several lead changes and several ties. Maybe team really running away from each other. See what the Golden Lions want to do with it here. 24 on the shot clock. Vargas is going to inbound it from Pine Bluff. Gets it to Williams in the corner. Now Brown. His pass stolen. Bell with the steal, but right back is Parchman in transition. And then Parchman nearly gets it knocked out of bounds here. It'll be UAPB basketball after all that. In about three or four possession changes in about 7 seconds. So the Golden Lions will inbound it. 7:05 to play before halftime, leading by one, 24-23. We got Morris, Williams, Stokes, Vargas, and Parchman, the five on the floor for Pine Bluff. Knocked out of bounds by Prairie View with 18 on the shot clock. Just knocked it out of bounds. Shot clock at 18, 6:55 on the game clock. Here is Williams, passes up the three this time. Pull up, 10-footer, no good. Passed up a good shot for a great shot, but couldn't knock it down. So Prairie View will have a chance to take the lead here. Almost a turnover there. Chasing it down was Gamble. And picked off. Here is Vargas in transition, a little Euro step. And there's a lot of contact. He wanted a foul call, no call. Thought it was a clean block, I guess. Here on the other end, too strong off the glass for Gambrill, knocked out of bounds. Gonna be Pine Bluff ball, I believe. It's gonna be Prairie View ball. Cox will inbound it for the Panthers. They'll put 20 on the shot clock. And a little baseline shot, no good. Whistle, foul called. It's gonna be on Morris, his second. Team foul number nine. Or is it eight? Yep, nine. Oh, they just went to 10. Milton's gonna check in for Vargas. Free throws coming up here for Daniels. Misses the first. Morris will check out. Doolittle in. 6:05 to play. First half. Juwan Daniels, second shot. Gets the bounce. 6 minutes to go before halftime. UAPB and Prairie View A&M tied at 24 here. Almost a turnover. Doolittle going to get him with a double dribble or travel. Turnover's going to give it back to Prairie View. We've gotten a little sloppy here in the last couple minutes. Had a nice flow to this game early. But the last few minutes has gotten a little sloppy. Gambrell. They work it around here. He'll take the three. Gambrell, top of the key. It's good. And Gambrell, that's his third three of the first half. He's got 9 points. Back on the other end. Shot up Doolittle, no good. Quickly back. Panthers in the lane. Kick out. It's going to be Gambrell again for three, and he connects again from the left wing. And he's got 12 points in the contest, all from three-point land. Four big threes for Gambrell, and the largest lead of the game here for Prairie View. They lead 30-24. 30-second timeout called by Coach Bozeman. We'll keep it here. And 5:14 remaining. Before halftime, the Golden Lions will have the ball and resume play down by six. Gabriel Vargas will check in here during the timeout. Lions will inbound it down six with 5:14 to play. Be Daquan Morris. Williams, bring it up. No pressure. Top of the key. Now that will bring a late trap here. Blocking foul is going to be called. Is that Cox with the foul, please? Oh, called it on Brian Miles, rather. 17 fouls and first on Miles. 1-1 here for Sean Williams. First shot is good. One more coming up for Williams. He's got four in the game. Knocks them both down. 30-26. 4-point lead for Prairie View, and they have the basketball here. 4:50 to play. Late first half. Top of the key, three, yes sir. Juwan Daniels, Prairie View's gotten hot all of a sudden from three, and they lead it by seven. Here's Williams trying to match him, misses his three. Rebound coming the other way is Daniels. Right side, long three, and it goes again for Jeremiah Gambrell. He's got 5 3-point shots made in the first half, and he's hit three in basically the last four possessions. 36-26, all of a sudden, a quick 10-point lead here for Prairie View. Here's Williams. Golden Lions trying to keep up with him. Nice shot off the curl. Long two for Morris. 36-28, Morris with 8 first half points. Gambrell, they're checking him now. Here's Daniels. Nice dump off underneath. The assist by Daniels, the easy two for Miles. 10-point lead for Prairie View, 38-28. Needing some help. Williams is trapped. Now gets it to Stokes. Spotting up for three. Now the dish off Morris. And going to have a foul on the drive. Brandon Brown was fouled. And they're going to get Miles. Got a media timeout here. We'll step aside. Take a 1 minute break. The sizzling hot Prairie View A&M Panthers. They lead it by 10 over the Golden Lions, 38-28 with 3:17 to go before halftime. This is the UAPB Sports Network. Back in 1 minute.
And Adidas is a proud apparel partner for UAPB Athletics. Are you living the three-strike life?
Killed the Golden Lions from three-point range, mainly due to the fact of Jeremiah Gambrell's five made threes in the first half. Juwan Daniels hit one a moment ago as well. But this was a game that was tied at 24, and all of a sudden a 14-4 run for the Panthers to take a 10-point lead. And down to nine as Brandon Brown hits the free throw. Brown now with five first half points. Junior guard out of Memphis will have another. And makes them both. Milton will check in for, let's see, for Morris. So the Golden Lions cut it to eight. 3:15 to play before halftime, 38-30 Prairie View. And they have the basketball. Gambrell. Daniels in the corner it goes. Open three and it is good for Dwayne Cox. 11-point lead. Panthers continue to do big damage from three. Oh, he drug that pivot foot. Tried to slam on the brakes, but just drug it an inch or two there, and that's all it takes. The turnover, give it back to Prairie View, 41-30 with 2:40 to play before halftime. The Golden Lions gonna commit a silly foul there. Milton just runs up on the back of Gambrell and picks up the foul. He's got two now. And it's double bonus, so two free throws coming up here for Jeremiah Gambrell.
Shooting double bonus will be number 10, Jeremiah Gambrell.
And a little flat on that shot. No good. One more coming up. He likes shooting a three better than the the closer shots, apparently. He does make one of two there. So Gambrill now with 16 points leadoff scores. He's got 16 of the 42 for Prairie View as they lead UAPB by 12. 42 to 30, 225 and counting before halftime. Brown, he'll take the three, book it. Big three for Brandon Brown on the right wing. He's got 9 first half points to lead the way for UAPB. They've cut it to 9. See if they can build some momentum off of that. So they look to press and trap. Daniels picks up his dribble. Now they're on Cox out high here. And he's going to be fouled right into the sideline. Look out, that's our women's basketball head coach there, Don Thornton, about had a player in her lap over there. Those courtside seats put you right in the game.
Sending Dwayne Cox to the line for the double bonus.
And a foul, though, it's going to be 2 more free throws, double bonus, and Cox makes the first. Parchman's going to check in for Strenick. One more coming up here for Dwayne Cox, and he's got 6 first half points with 1:58 left before halftime, and he's thinking of another 7 points now. And lead back up to 11, 44-33. Baseline drive, kick out, Milton for 3, rimmed out, no good. And I'm gonna say Brown last touched it for Pine Bluff, so Prairie View A&M's gonna get it back here with 1:45 to go before halftime and leading by 11. Golden Lions wanna show some pressure here. And able to get it across the timeline was Douglas. Now they'll set it up here with Gambrill. 1:30 left before half. Quiet crowd on hand as Prairie View's shooting has taken the wind out of their sails. He has to shoot this three with the shot clock down to 1. They get an offensive rebound. And it resets to 20. And they'll set it up. Gambrill takes his time, top of the key. Milton's right there with him. Now lob it on the right baseline. I have a push off foul on Will Douglas.
Offensive foul, foul on number 21, Will Douglas. That's his second personal and the 19th foul. Re-entering for the Panthers, number 1, D'Angelo Ware.
Stops the clock at 57 seconds. Now we're rolling. Goal line still down 11, though. Kind of close out this first half. Regroup. Williams trying to dump it off. Good hand stolen by Cox. Ahead to Daniels. He throws it down with the right hand. It's an easy transition dunk. 46-33. 30 seconds left. This is the biggest lead for Prairie View, up 13 here. Here's Brown. All right. Block kicks it out. Williams spots up for 3. No good. Williams, or Brown rather, keeps it alive with the offensive rebound inside to Parchman. And as he took that entry pass, he was fouled before the shot. But he will shoot a 1-1, though. I was going to say 2 shots. Yeah, double bonus, 2 shots.
Shooting the double bonus with number 22, Omar Parchman.
So 10.7 seconds, Parchman. Too strong on the first. They'll have 1 more coming up. Vargas back in as Williams checks out. 1 more coming up for Parchman. They're going to mop up the floor, maybe some sweat. Little sweat droplets hit the floor and can make it a little treacherous. For the footing of the players. 1 more shot. And too strong on both there. Missed the second, back ironed it. Yeah, we got it. What do we have here? Was it a timeout? Oh. Yes, they. They called a timeout. So I was trying to say that Will Douglas, number 21, called the timeout. 6.9 seconds left, so Prairie View will have the final shot of the half here, leading, playing with house money up by 13. Well played first half for Prairie View. The Golden Lions battled hard. We were tied at 24, and since then, a 22-9 spurt for Prairie View here in the final 8 minutes of this first half. And mostly done on the three-point shot. No inbound it, seven now. Gambrill turns, spins, three, this time no good, and we are at halftime.
And that concludes the first half, ladies and gentlemen.
46-33 our score. And the head coach for Prairie View, Byron Smith, is livid, screaming, wanting the officials to look something to see how much time was left on the clock. I'm not exactly sure what happened there. They're going to come over and look at something. So before we, I guess that is going to be the end of the first half. So we'll take a, for our radio listeners, a 5 minute timeout, and then I'll have LaRon Marbley hosting an interview after that. We are at the half here, 46-33, Prairie View in their 3-point shooting, leading the Golden Lions by 13 here at the half. This is the UAPB Sports Network, back after this.
The H.O. Clemens Arena here at the half, and our score, Golden Lions trail at the moment, 46-33. LaRon Marbley here, sitting in at the half. Of course, Tim Stubbs handling the play-by-play duties, and I'm here with UAPB football quarterback Skylar Perry. What's going on, my man?
How you doing? Everything good?
Good, good. Now, what I see, and of course, ladies and gentlemen out there, we talked about it earlier, we're going to try to do some interviews at the halftime with players, former players, and things like that. And of course, we have the man, Skylar Perry, quarterback for the Golden Lions. And you guys, and I just love to see it, man. It's just wonderful to see you guys coming out, and you see all the sports doing this, supporting the other sports, man. And that has to make you guys feel good as they support you all as well.
Almost definitely. It's all about building a culture, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know what I'm saying, it's a winning culture at that. So, you know what I'm saying, everybody pushing each other to achieve the same goals, then that's the chemistry and that's the atmosphere you're going to be in. You know what I'm saying? Anybody that come in here, it's going to be a hostile environment. Anytime you pull up in Pine Bluff, just know that.
Yes, sir. And it's supposed to be. You guys do a great job heckling the coaches and the players and stuff like that. I love it, though. I love it. And that's great to see that support within the athletics department. Each team supporting each team. Now, of course, this year you guys actually get to have a spring practice instead of a season this year. And what are you guys doing right now in football?
A lot of weightlifting, but you know what I'm saying? We also taking the initiative to try to get ahead. You know what I'm saying? A lot of guys come out on a day-to-day. You know what I'm saying? We do a lot of entity by ourselves. You know what I'm saying? Our coaches come out one time a week to get a lot of individual with us, meetings and things like that, finna start back. So, you know what I'm saying? We trying to get ahead of the game. You know what I'm saying? We 2-9, and that's enough to say about itself.
So, absolutely.
2-9. You know what I'm saying? You don't want that feeling no more.
Right. Got to build on that. And what would be some of the main focuses that, you individually, what do you be focused on this spring to try to improve on?
A lot of strength. Okay. Mainly for everybody. But individually, you know what I'm saying? Mainly just making sure my team is grounded. Because a lot of guys, you know what I'm saying? They focus on the negative. You know what I'm saying? So keeping those guys in the positive mindset, you know what I'm saying? A lot of positive energy. And make sure everybody is held accountable at the same level. Even myself.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And so I know know you're fired up and ready for the next season, man, and I know you guys can do well. Of course, it was kind of tough last year. A lot of people don't realize, and they forget, playing a spring season, then turn around playing a fall season. Making no excuses, though, but that is very, very difficult, especially when you're talking about football. We've seen it happen when they had the bubble with the basketball the next year. The Lakers had a lot of injuries and players. So that is very, very tough. So you guys will be kind of able to recuperate and get a little bit better this spring.
Yeah, and that's what we've been working on also a lot. Coach doing a great job with us in the weight room. You know what I'm saying? A lot of guys, you know what I'm saying, getting a lot of strength, mobility, flexibility, things like that, because injuries can hinder you. Like I said, we played that spring, then we came back and played the fall. We had a lot of injuries in the season, and that showed. So this year, you know what I'm saying, spring, we building a lot of strength, speed, you know what I'm saying? Coach make sure we stretch and take care of our body and things like that.
Absolutely. Well, I'm excited about it, my man, and I definitely want to thank you for coming on. And definitely want to wish you luck for next season.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it.
UAPB quarterback Skylar Perry here at the half of the UAPB versus Prairie View A&M. The Golden Lions trail at the half, 46-33. We'll take a two-minute break, and when we return, we have the exciting second half here from the H.O. Clemens Arena. You're tuned in to UAPB basketball on the UAPB Sports Network and 99.3 The Beat. We'll be back in 2 minutes.
Back inside of H.O. Clemens Arena, Tim Stubbs, and special thanks to LaRon Marbley. It's actually a big help, especially when you're broadcasting the game solo, to have a guy like LaRon step in and give me a little bit of a breather, a little bit of a break in between halftime. Definitely a big help. Of course, LaRon works, as you know, at 99.3 FM, The Beat, and does the public address announcing for football and basketball as well here at UAPB, and does a great job. Prairie View with the basketball. First possession of the second half. It's going to be a turnover on Prairie View as they tried to work it inside. Pass too hot to handle. So the Gold Lions down by 13. This first 5-6 minutes of the second half going to be large here to try to get back in this game, in large part because of the three-point shooting. And here's a steal by Cox. He's going to go all the way with a left-handed layup in the lead. Quickly up to 15, but in that first half, 8 of 13 from 3 was Prairie View. UAPB is solid as well, 6 of 14, but 62% for Prairie View, in large part was 5 made threes by Jeremiah Gambrell. Got a whistle and foul. It's going to be on Juwan Daniels. As Gambrell had 16 in the first half, Daniels, who just committed the foul, he had 9. Leading the way is Brandon Brown with 10 points for UAPB. He's at the foul line as we speak. And makes the first free throw. Brown now 3 of 3 from the foul line. Hasn't missed a field goal either. 3 of 3 from the field. Has 5 rebounds. A couple of assists, 2 steals. Just done a little bit of everything, including missing that free throw there with my jinx. 48 to 34, UAPB down by 14. Just 1 minute into the second half. A lot of game left. Golden Lions can get back into it. It is warm in here tonight. And I'm not talking about just the shooting. Pretty decent crowd on hand as well. After the foul called, they call a blocking foul. See what the call is. They come over here.
It did go in.
They're gonna take a look at it, and the replay is. I didn't see it. I'm about to find out here. That did go in. So they're gonna count it, and they wanted to make sure the shot went in. Either way, it's gonna be.
Ref. It was a foul.
The foul was on Daquan Morse. Called him for a block there. Maybe he was in the restricted area. That was close. Good replay. So they count the basket. And that's going to be it's going to be Gambrell at the line. And he completes the three-point play. So Gambrell, I'm not sure. That should have been an and one. I think he's got 19. It's 51-34. Largest lead of the game here for Prairie View, 18-37 to play. Morris, rise and fire from the foul line. No good. Battle for the rebound. Got a whistle on the floor. And it's going to be on UAPB. Call it on Parchman. Gambrell brings it up, picked up by Stokes. Golden Lions got to make something happen, try to get back in this game. We were all tied at 24 at one point. And then that's a big block for Parchman. Golden Lions, though, in transition, turn it right back over. Gambrell. Now right side, Cox for three and hits. Dwayne Cox. And we got a little chippiness going on after the basket. The officials, and they're gonna say it was on Bell. It's a warning. Or no, they called a foul. Clear out. Said he was clearing out. They count the basket. 54-34. It's 12 in the game now for Cox. 17:56 remaining. Second half, it's now a 20-point lead for Prairie View. As they are starting to pull away, the Golden Lions got plenty of time to get back into it. They're going to have to hurry up. Missed shot, the lob on the other end, and they get the easy stick back after he was able to get control. Timeout called. Daniels gets the basket. And an immediate timeout, so we'll take this 1 minute break here. Coach Bozeman had to call a timeout there, but it will be served as a media timeout. So 17:38 to play, so a lot of game left, but Prairie View leading the Golden Lions by 22, 56-34. This is the UAPB Sports Network back after this timeout. Side of H.O. Clemens Arena, Tim Stubbs here on the UAPB Sports Network and our crew here tonight. Glad to be back on our television, our stream and YouTube channel, UAPB Television. Good to have Randy Kelly back with us. TV side, we got some great camera angles from our students. Getting a chance to get some experience and be a part of our crew. So I missed the last homestand, was out with illness, and back for this one. We have three straight home games tonight. Of course, the next round, Monday night, Texas Southern, and then next weekend, next Saturday, close out the regular season with Mississippi Valley State. Right now, the Golden Lions got their hands full and then some, and that's an ugly foul. That was a breakaway by Gambrill, and Stokes kind of got him around the neck area, and they're probably going to come over and look at this to see if it was a flagrant one or two, or if Coach Bozeman wants to know what you're looking at. He just thought it was he feels his player went for the ball. I believe he was trying to go for the ball too, but we'll see from this angle, and he just kind of came down hard with that right hand, but he did look like he was slapping at the ball from our angle on the DV Sports angle. I'm not sure on our TV side if, yep, no replay on the TV side of it. So looking over here at the top shot on the DV Sports, looks like they got a pretty quick, it may call a flagrant one. I don't believe it was a flagrant two in any stretch of the imagination. I believe that's what he just said, a flagrant one.
And the previous foul was called on Keshawn Stokes to be a flagrant one foul.
And Coach Bozeman still pleading his case. It basically serves like a technical. Now, if it was a flagrant two, a grade two flagrant foul, it would have been an automatic ejection. So I believe that was the right call. It's kind of a compromise. It wasn't just a common foul. It had a little extra to it. A guy in the air like that, thankfully he's okay, but I know Stokes was going for the ball, but he did it in a manner that was a little more than common, so I believe flagrant one would suffice. That's just my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. 17-25 left, still a lot of game, but unfortunately Prairie View's pulling away here, up by 24. Their largest lead of the game, as both free throws were good by Gambrill, who's had a monster game. He's got 21 now. And they'll get the basketball back here. 22 on the shot clock. As Douglas trying to inbound it. Gets it to Daniels. And stripped and stolen here by Brandon Brown. Brown behind the back dribble, top of the key. He's calling for Brown to drive on him. He does, kicks it out. Milton for three, front iron, no good. Old Lions, in the worst way, need a basket. Step back 15-footer off the mark for Douglas. Brown the rebound, he pushes, kicks it out. Milton left wing, down low, and scoring inside is Morris. Daquan Morris, the basket. Cuts it to 22. Cox wants to drive, dumps it off to Bell in the lane, and it's going to be Daniels for the lay-in, the assist by Bell.
Assist,
13 now for Daniels, and Prairie View up by 24. Strong drive and take by Brandon Brown. He's got 12 in the game now. Ahead to Daniels. Transition lob, the dunk, no good, missed it. That was Douglas who missed the lob. UAPB back on the other end, trying to show him how it's done. And Morris couldn't handle the pass, but they keep it alive and get a stick back and a foul. Stokes maybe, we'll get another media timeout here. We'll step aside. 15, 58 to play. Take a 1 minute break here. This is the UAPB Sports Network's coverage of Golden Lion basketball. Prairie View leading UAPB 60 to 40 with 15, 58 to play. Back after this timeout. Side of H.O. Clemens Arena, 15-58 to play in the ball game, and the Golden Lions just trying to. Seems like it had a little short in it. Let's see if we're still on the air here. Test mic check. Yeah, had a little short in it there. We good? we have courtside. If you could see how this thing is set up, guys, you would probably be laughing along with me. But I can't. If I breathe a little too heavy and things get touched ever so slightly, we might go off the air. I think we're still good. All right. Appreciate it, LaRon. Not a lot of room over here, if you know what I mean. We're going to fix that for next game. 15-50 to play as we strive to stay on the air. Simulcasting, TV and radio, streaming. Having a media frenzy here tonight. 62-41, 15-49. Here in the second half, 21-point lead for Prairie View. Golden Lions just trying to get back into it somehow, some way. Tip back is there for Morris. Gets it down to 19. Largest deficit was 24. Cross-court pass to Douglas. Daniels have come out for it out high here. Picked up by Williams. Gambrel inside and just stays with it. And bucket's good for Jeremiah Kendall.
Back up. Just back up.
64-43. 3-point shot. Milton left wing, no good. Nice offensive rebound by Stokes, and he's fouled. Go, 14-54 left. Still a lot of game. Two shots coming up here for Kayshawn Stokes. He's got 8 points in the game. And missed the first one off to the right. One more coming up. One more for Stokes. Junior guard out of Headland, Alabama. Makes one of two. He's got 9 in the game. whistle, and boy, as soon as he made the free throw and guards the inbounds and picks up a foul before he even inbounded it. That's his first team foul, number six already. We're just 5 minutes into the second half. We got 16 fouls. It's gonna be a lot of free throws down the final 10 minutes. There's another one there almost, as Stokes kind of ran up on the back of Gambrell. Shot clock 15. Right side of the floor he goes. Turning, spinning, shot up, and somehow kindled. Had to go in and halfway in and out. Here's the left-handed layup try by Cox, no good. And gonna have a foul on the rebound. It's gonna go against Prairie View as they fouled Morris. Third on Will, or Jeremiah Kendall, rather. 14:22 to play, second half. 64-44, 20-point lead for Prairie View. Williams gets a screen from Milton. Milton now will attack. Nice pass. Beautiful half-court set, but just couldn't finish. Brandon Brown misses the shot inside. Well designed. Got to finish it off. Look out. About to come. I was ready, LaRon. Thought he was about to jump in our laps. Knocked out of bounds. Going to be Golden Lion basketball. 64-44. Golden Lions got to get after it here. Down 20. Another foul. We're going to have guys foul out of this one. That's already the 16 foul on both teams. We're 7 minutes into the second half. We have a total of 12 fouls called, almost averaging two fouls a minute. Yeah, we're going to run out of players if we're still on this pace. There's another one. Wow. It is a foul festivity. A foul festival. As Will Douglas, and that one's called on Jeremiah Kendall, and that's his fourth. He goes to the sideline. Maybe the Golden Lions can creep back into this game from the foul line. They're free. Take them. And make them. And that's what he does. Brandon Brown got 13 in the game now. One more coming up. Takes his time, knocks it in. I know it's still an 18-point game. This is the closest UAPB's been in a while. 64-46, 13-45 remaining. And trying to press a little bit. Gambrell drives right around it. And tries to do it again in the corner to Cox. Cox, strong drive. Pretty solid defense. Thought Milton was straight up, but shot goes and one. Cox. He's got 14 in the game now. One shot coming up for Cox, trying to complete the three-point play. Well, Cox now is 16 in the game. 13:32 to go. Lead back to 20. Shot in and out, no good. Rebound, Pine Bluff. Down 20 with the ball, 13 and a half to play. Almost a steal there. Drive, kick in the corner. Doolittle for three. Yes, sir. Javonte Doolittle, senior guard out of Hughes, Arkansas. Hits the big three, cuts it to a 17-point game. That's the first points of the night for Doolittle. Here's the drive by Ware. all the way. The take, misses it inside. Offensive rebound, Daniels, he's fouled. Going back up for the shot. They'll say one and one. That's crazy, right? 15 fouls called combined, and we've only played 7 minutes in the second half. First shot is good. Having a good game is Juwan Daniels, looking for his 15th point. Will not get it here. Rebound Brown. Thought about the three again. Doolittle right side to Brown. Williams has been rather quiet tonight. He can get hot in a hurry. Brown thought about the three. He'll take the baseline drive, kick out. Doolittle for three, yes sir. Doolittle doing a lot from downtown. Back-to-back threes. Yeah, I was sitting on that one for a while. A steal, scoring and one. Daquan Morris. And the Golden Lions coming alive here with 12-12 to play. 67-54. Cut it down to 13. Once trailed by as many as 24, the Golden Lions trying to get back in this. It's a quick 8-0 run here. And shot is good. Got it down to 12, 67-55. Cut the lead in half. A lot of game left. Cox, here's Bell. Turns, goes up with the right hand. Nice in the lane, scores with the soft touch of the right hand. And a technical foul is issued. Loose lips, talking trash. And I believe they're gonna get Daniels. Juwan Daniels is pleading his case, but
media timeout.
Nevertheless, we got a media timeout, so we'll step aside here as they step through this technical. 69-55 our score with 11:55 to go. The Gold Lions trying to get back in this one. This is UAPB Sports Network's coverage of Golden Lion basketball, back in 1 minute. Delay of game. Called a delay of game. And was it a delay of game technical? Just a warning, delay of game warning. If it does it again, then it's technical. So had to clear that up. 69-55, Golden Lions inbounded here. Down by 14, 11:45 to play. Here's Doolittle. Kick out, Williams for three, off the mark. Up high, look at Stokes. Man, can that guy jump. Woo. He can get up pound for pound. He's got bunnies. I'll match up with anybody. He couldn't get the rebound, but he had his hand on it. My gracious. That is a throwaway turnover. Coach Thornton over there on the sideline. She was ready to shoot the J from the out of bounds courtside seats. Of course, she's in a good mood. Her Lady Lions sweeping Prairie View this year, pulling to within 7-7. I believe in conference play now in the standings. Got a big matchup on Monday night against Texas Southern before closing it out against Valley, but Lady Lions have had a really nice year and continuing to get better. Here's Morris, kick out, top of the key, Stokes, he'll take the three, not this time. And rebound pulled down by the Panthers. Prairie View up 14. Golden Lions trailed by as many as 24 and cut it in half to 12. Daniels kicks it out. Cox the drive and the left-handed layup. Strong take. He's having a solid game now. 18 in the contest for Dwayne Cox. Nice drive here on the other end. Counted in one for Brandon Brown. Brown with 16 to lead the way for the Golden Lions.
The team's ninth. Basket is good. Shooting one, Brandon Brown.
They'll have one here. Ninth team foul on Prairie View, and that is the fourth, I believe, on Markedrick Bell. Golden Lions with 18 fouls, 17 total fouls called already. We're not at the halfway point of the second half. It's crazy. 71-58, 13-point lead for Prairie View. Still a lot of game left. Golden Lions not giving anything away. Ooh, that had some heat on it. Coming in hot as it went off the side of, hit maybe the shoulder of a cheerleader, but it was coming in crispy hot. A little no-look pass. They weren't expecting it. Man, let's hope she's gonna be okay. I believe so. Everyone's laughing about it. It's a good sign. Here's a three. Gambrill again this time. Missed it. And the rebound, Brown, ahead to Doolittle. Milton, they're working around the perimeter here, 9:50 to play. Golden Lions down 13. Looking for a screen from Stokes, strong drive, and Brown's fouled on the way to the basket. It's going to be two shots. That's 10 team fouls now anyway on Prairie View. So the Golden Lions will be shooting double bonus the rest of the game. 9:41 left. And Prairie View's not far behind them because the Golden Lions have 8 team fouls. I could see where we were headed early in the second half with the fouls mounting as quickly as they were. It's going to be a lot of free throws in this ball game, and the first shot is good for Brandon Brown. One more coming up here. And he's got both of them, and the lead down to 11, the closest the Golden Lions have been in a long time. 19 in the game for Brown. Little floater on the baseline, no good. Shot up by Douglas, but a foul is called. And they're gonna get Brown on the foul. And jeez. Third on Brown, and that's now 19 total fouls. And they're staying on that pace, two fouls a minute in this second half.
Makes the front end, one side remaining.
not going to have any players left at the end of this one. Douglas knocks him in, lead back to 13, 9.5 to play. Douglas with 5 in the game. Stokes top of the key here. Morris, turnaround, jumper from 15, short, no good. Rebound, Panthers, they'll slowly bring it up here. Just over 9 minutes to play now. Strong drive, shot up, Gambrill is short. 73-60, Golden Lions down 13 with a basketball here. Just under 9 to play. Brown, he'll take the three. They're going to leave him open. He's short on it. Put back, follow, dunk. Morris went up to throw it down and wouldn't go down. He was there. And Prairie View trying to save it. And they run over my guy, IC Mural, over there. I think he was already on the ground. He was taking some pictures. He's okay. 73-60. 8:40 to play. And the Golden Lions inbounded here to Brown. Brown drives right baseline. Now in and out of the lane he goes. Now he takes it up with a left hand. He's fouled. Like I said, I'm going to have a lot of free throws. Two more coming up for Brown.
And Brown will be shooting the double bonus.
Two more coming up here for Brown. He's got 19 points in the game. And in and out, no good. Gonna need all these. Missing both. Boy, those are tough misses for Brown. Gotta have all these. Gonna try to come back and win this game. 13-point lead, losing it, trying to go behind his back was Douglas. Now off of Morris and out of bounds. .820 to go. Inbounded here. Gambrill trying to get a screen from Daniels. Gambrill still with the bounce to Daniels. Back to Gambrill. 15 on the shot clock. Good defense here by Williams. Step back jumper is good. Gambrill with a tough two there. He's got 23 lead off scores. Brown stays with it, gets the second chance. Cox will bring it ahead here. .75-62. Another foul call. It's going to be the fourth on Brown. 10th team foul. 7:21 to go. We'll step aside. 75-62 our score. Prairie View leading the Golden Lions by 13. Take a 1 minute timeout here. This UAPB Sports Network's coverage of Golden Lion basketball. Back after this. operator. Shahid Evans. Shahid. Kamon Frazier. Desiree McCool. Back inside, H.O. Clements Arena, 7:21 to play. 75-62 UAPB trying to hang in there. Trailed by as many as 24 here in this second half and cut it to as low as 11, down 13 right now, but they're fighting. UAPB transfer, Markedrick Bell. He's at the foul line. Two shots coming up, double bonus, both teams from here on out. Bill's first shot off the back of the iron, no good. One more coming up from Bill. And he missed both, boy. I'm telling you, Morris and Stokes, I need a jump off, guys. I could watch those guys jump all day. Kick out, Williams for three, book it. Sean Williams, 10-point game. Here come the Golden Lions, 7 to play. Still fighting. Williams now with 8. His second three made. Another came early in the first half. Almost a turnover there. And Gamble on the floor with it. Anybody's ball, tie up or a foul? Now they're going to call tie up. Alternating possession. The Golden Lion basketball. .6:31 to go, 10-point game. Golden Lions will get it back here down 10. Morris is gonna inbound it here to Brown. .6:25 to play. Here's Brown. Kick out Williams. Thought about the three there. Would have liked to have pulled the trigger on it. Step back. Passes it up to Brown. Brown in the corner now. Williams. Step back three is good. Yes, sir. It's a 7-point game. Down by as many as 24. They've cut it to 7. With 6 minutes to play, this game is not over, folks. Going to Bell on the baseline. Can't get it to go. Rebound, Williams. Look out now. Big possession here. Here's Brown. Here's Doolittle, 18 on the shot clock. Got to come get it. Here's Williams now. Tip back-to-back threes. 75-68, 5.5 to play. Here's the drive, a fadeaway off the glass, no good. What an offensive rebound, Stokes, but he traveled, I believe. They're gonna call a tie-up as he went up. And it's gonna go in the favor of, gonna go in, oh, now they changed the call. Let's see. Got all kinds of stuff going on here. It's going to be UAPB basketball, and they do get the shot clock reset. Maybe catch a break there. Here's Brown, goes up strong off the glass, no good. Whistle, foul. Two shots coming up for UAPB. Will Douglas picks up his third. 5:12 to go. Golden Lions have a chance here to trim this thing down to five. Yeah, but Brown all of a sudden has got cold from 3-point or from the foul line. And it's time for him to start picking it back up. And he gets the ladder. 75-69. The Golden Lions got it down to six. Daniels picked up by Morris. Shot clock at 15. Daniels wants to go one on one. The drive and rejected by Morris. Get it out of here. They stay with it though on the second chance effort by Gambrell. And boy, these guys are competing. Timeout called by Prairie View after the basket. Great block by Morris for Knott as Gambrell scored his 25th point of the game on that second chance effort. 4:44 to go. 77-69, an 8-point lead. Let's see if the Golden Lions can continue their momentum here. They've been getting it done defensively. UAPB will inbound it here, down by 8, 4:40 to play. 77-69. Here's Brown, going to have an illegal screen on Sean Williams. The foul fest continues. Second on Williams. These live stats here, LaRon. Let's see if we can try to keep up with these fouls. In this game, there's been a total of 43 fouls called. We got 4.5 minutes to play. My heavens. Inbounded here. It's going to be goal line basketball after, fouls and turnovers becoming huge. 17 turnovers by Prairie View. Williams hits another big basket. This time it was a two. Cuts it back to six. 77-71. 4:09 to play. Big possession here. Four to play. Here's the drive. Cox baseline off the glass. In and out. In and out. Doolittle keeps it alive. Rebound to Williams. Williams off the bounce. Each possession
work out.
Long three, Williams. Book it. Yes, sir. It is a 3-point game. 77-74. Almost a steal by Brown there. A ball fake, jumper from 10, good. Morris keeps it calm, 16 in the game for Daniels, rather. 79-74, 3:13 to play. We've got a whistle, and what do we have now? Yeah, it's getting chippy out there. Let's see what they're going to call now. I mean, they have called a lot of fouls, first of all. And it has gotten heated at moments. 43 total fouls called. We're going to have a media timeout here, and we'll sort things out when we come back. How about that? 3:13 remaining in the ball game, and it's been a good one. The Golden Lions got it down to 5. They were down by 24. This is UAPB Golden Lion basketball on the UAPB Sports Network. Don't miss the finish of this one. Back after this timeout. Remaining. Winning time in this game has been something else. 79-74. This was a 24-point lead for Prairie View early in the second half. The Golden Lions just kept scratching and clawing their way back and cut it to 3. Technical foul called. Drawing. Free throw and called it on UAPB. Who was the technical on? Bench. Caught on the UAPB bench, so some mouthing from the sideline the officials didn't like. Oh, now steal. Good night. Steal by Douglas. Oh, and a block by Morris. Kept alive by Cox, however. As 2 times Morris has come up and volleyball spiked it, but can't retain possession after. But they love the effort, 79-74. There's a fight for it at midcourt. Kept alive, 8 on the shot clock. Cox, the drive, up and under. What a nifty play by Cox. Oh, just leaned in right over the defender. He's got 20 in the game, 81-74. Mercy. Oh, that's a, should have been a foul there on Douglas. Here's Williams. Step back, long 2 is good. Let's say a 2-pointer. Boy, he has come alive though. 18 the game now for Mr. Sean Williams. 81-76, still 2 minutes to go. Anybody's game. Cox will hold it here. And now out high, Gambrell, the drive in the lane is short. Oh, they bail him out with the foul. Morris in disbelief. Kind of a late call there, and it's bailed out, and fortunately that's the 5th foul, and Brandon Brown, spectacular game, fouls out with 22 points. Live stats got him with 23. 6 of 9 from the field, 9 of 13 from the foul line, 10 rebounds, 5 assists, 3 steals. Heck of a game for Brandon Brown. So 1:56 to go. Jeremiah Gambrell, all he's done is score 27 tonight. Make it 28. He does have 6 turnovers. That's really the only glitch on the scorecard. But he is 5 of 10 from 3, 4 or 5 of 6 from the foul line, 3 rebounds, 4 assists. He's now got 29 in the game. And the lead back to 7. 150 to play, 83-76. Here's Williams. Can he stay hot? Top of the key, Stokes, the strong drive with a left hand off the glass. Going to draw the foul and shoot 2. And Stokes with 9 points in the game. He's 3 of 4 from the line tonight. Big free throws coming up here, 1:41 to go. First shot is good. One more coming up, cuts it to 6. Stokes. 83-78. And he got hit in the mouth there. That was Gambrel. Let me come look at this because it was above the shoulders. Caught a block. Going to be the 4th on Stokes. Team foul number 57 is what it feels like. And it's total of 3 fouls instead of 4, but total of 23 fouls on the Golden Lions in the game. 22 fouls on Prairie View. 24 fouls now, rather. We've had a lot of free throws. Golden Lions from 19 to 26 from the foul line. And Prairie View 20 of 28, I believe. And makes both shots. 85-78, 7-point lead. 29, now 30 for Gambrel. Shot up in the lane by Milton. He draws the foul. He's going to shoot 2. 1:26 remaining. And that's another one fouled out. Another one bites the dust, right? Will Douglas is fouled out. Milton, he has 3 points in the game. And missed the foul shot. Go Lions. Shot at 73% before that miss. We'll take that pretty much every night, but it's missed some big ones down the stretch here. Get the bounce. Cuts it to 6 with 1:20 to play. A steal by Williams. Milton can't get it to go, and he's going to shoot 2 more. Oh, my. Needed that to go down. 1:20 to go. Knock these foul shots down, Mr. Milton. Transfer from Western Kentucky. And back ironed it. Need them. Gotta have them. Kylan Milton, sophomore guard. By way of Conway, Arkansas. And we got a little blood on the face of Gambrel. Looks like he's all right.
Let's go. I know. His mom didn't be sued, goddamn. I can't talk.
All right, we're back to the action. 1 free throw remaining for Milton.
1:20 to play. 1 more free throw coming up. And he just can't get it to go. Keeping it alive was Doolittle, and he lost it off the fingertips. And Milton missing 3 of 4 on those last 2 trips. had their chances. Still over a minute to play. Down six. Got to have some stops and scores and a foul. Hopefully miss free throws. And he's fouled out. Of course, I told you there's going to be a lot of guys foul out. I mean, we've had a lot of fouls called in this game. Almost 50 total fouls called in this game. Going to bring in Isaiah Harrelson off the bench. Junior going out of Pearland, Texas. His first action tonight. First shot is good for Cox. He's played a great game as well. He's got 21 in the game. He's 6 of 7 from the foul line, 6 of 8 from the floor. I mean, Prairie View has shot 54% for the game. The Golden Lions, a solid 44%. It's an 8-point lead for Prairie View. 1 minute to go. Here's Williams. The drive and another foul call on the way to the basket. And is anybody going to have players left? We'll see. Just the second throw on Cox. And finally, Williams knocks in the free throw here. He's got 22 in the game now. 4 of 10 from 3. The Golden Lions are 11 of 24 from 3. Prairie View 9 of 15. So threes have been big tonight. Cuts it to 6 after both free throws. 50 seconds left here on the run out. Cox slams on the brakes. And Morris with the foul. And Cox is going to go back to the line. Morris, yeah, he just fouled out. So I believe both teams have had three players foul out. That's the third on the Golden Lions. And I think two for. This is something else. 51 total fouls called. 26 for UAPB, 25 for Prairie View. 87-81. Now the Golden Lions are 22 of 32 from the foul line. And 24 of 34 for Prairie View from the foul line. One more coming up for Cox. And he knocks it in. He's got 23 in the game. 45 seconds left, 7-point lead. Here's Williams rising fire, and he's fouled on the three by Cox. He's going to shoot three. Why? And it's his fifth. And let's see. It's going to be three free throws. Or did they call that on Bell? I was thinking that was Cox, but may have been Bell. He fouled out. Three free throws coming up here for Williams. First shot is good. Sean Williams now 6 of 6 from the foul line. And 25th point of the ball game. Came out of nowhere here. Shot is good. A kick it ahead this time, going all the way for the layup. Cox after Williams made all three free throws. 30 seconds left, 6-point game. Vargas in the corner. Ball tipped and saved for a moment. Doolittle, timeout called, I believe, or they say stepped on the sideline. Oh no. Stepped on the sideline, let's see. Yeah, it's gonna be Prairie View ball, that's huge. 17 seconds left, now a foul, and
that was on Kayshawn Stokes.
And it's going to be the fourth on Stokes. '90-84. Make it 91-84, 16 seconds left. And this young man right here had a ball game, folks. 30 points tonight. He and along with Cox combined for over 50 together. And they were quite a tandem. And gives him 32 points in the contest. And 9 of 10 from the foul line. Here's a three, Williams. Look at Stokes trying to throw it down. That's going to pretty much about do it. Tie-up situation is going to be Prairie View basketball. And Prairie View is going to come away with the win here with 6 seconds left. But what a great effort by the Golden Lions, down by 24. Almost came all the way back to cut it to 3 late in the game. And coming back, but not enough. Prairie View A&M gets the road win here at Pine Bluff. A score of 92-84, high scoring affair with a plethora of fouls. Let's see if we're gonna have an interview with our coach here in just a moment.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please stand and just be going to have the play.
The alma mater, we're going to.
Let's
take a 1 minute timeout here and then we'll come back and wrap things up. A 1 minute break and then we'll come back and wrap things up. 92-84, the final. This is UAPB Golden Lions basketball. Back in 1 minute. Clemens Arena, they have the final touches there on the alma mater. Final score, Prairie View wins it, 92-84, the final. And boy, this box score just makes your head hurt. So much to look at. All the fouls called, one thing that stands out, 53 total fouls called in this ball game.
Once again, thank you for coming out, St. Charles, to your destinations. God bless.
cameo? We got any interview guys? No, no interview. No coaches interview tonight. Did he already leave? I was trying to see if we had Coach Bozeman, but I believe he went back with his team into the locker room. And so, Sean Williams, leading scorer tonight, 26 points. Had a monster second half. Had 8 points in the first half, so 18 in the second half. 23 for Brandon Brown. He fouled out. 9 rebounds, I believe. Nope. 10 rebounds, 23 and 10 for him. 12 points for Daquan Morris, 11 for Stokes, 6 for Doolittle on a couple of threes. 33 points for Jeremiah Gambrill. He had game-high honors. 25 for Dwayne Cox, 16 for Juwan Daniels. As Prairie View shot 58%. Let's see, for the game overall, shot 55%. That's amazing. 9 of 15 from three-point line. The Golden Lions, very solid for the game, 24 of 56, 43%. Solid clip from the three-point line, 11 of 25, and from the foul line, 25 of 35, that's 71%. But it wasn't enough. So, final score again, 92 to 84. Our help back in the studio, 99.3. 80. Haley, great job. I'm having to read lips over here. Haley, great job tonight back in the 99.3 The Beat studio. And for our crew here, Randy Kelly, a wonderful job. If we don't get knocked off the air, we got an avalanche of, it's been like, just knocked my, it's, okay, I think we're back. I don't know. We've got, no, it's like little mouse traps all over the place around here. It just takes, so I'm trying to give shout outs to our crew here to wrap up this evening. Our top shot, Shahid Evans, great job tonight. Kamon Frazier, Desiree McKenzie, and for Randy Kelly on our switcher and director, doing a fantastic job as well. LaRon helping out as always. Haley back in the studio, and I'm Tim Stubbs saying good night. A long night of basketball comes to an end. We'll see you back here against Texas Southern on Monday night. So long, good night, go Lions.